Hey, mathematicians! I'm Justin, and I've been on some really amazing trips lately. Check these out. Since I've been back, I've been thinking about adding some decorations to my room to remember my travels. So I started making some posters using photos from these trips. But, I think something's gone wrong along the way. Some look good, but there's something off about the others. Will you help me figure this out? Take a closer look at what I made. Pause here and take a moment to write down some observations about each poster in your notes. So, what do you think? This one shows me in front of the Empire State Building in New York City, and the poster is perfect. However, the posters of Mount St. Helens in Washington State and the beach along the Gulf of Mexico just seem off for some reason. I feel like I look funny in this poster. Look at the original photo I took on my phone. What do you think happened when I tried to enlarge this photo to turn it into a poster? Yeah, it looks like the picture was stretched really tall vertically. So now everything in the picture, including me, looks too tall and too thin. I guess just stretching a picture vertically doesn't keep the image the same. What about this one from the Gulf of Mexico? This is what the original image looked like. What do you think happened when I tried enlarging this photo? It seems like this one was stretched really wide horizontally, and now everything in the poster looks too short and too wide. I guess when you only stretch a picture horizontally, it doesn't keep it the same either. But I definitely stretched out the Empire State Building photo as well. So why did this poster come out correctly? Oh, I just realized, with the Mount St. Helens poster, I only stretched the picture vertically. And then with the Gulf of Mexico poster, I only stretched the picture horizontally. When I made the Empire State Building poster, I stretched it in both directions. That must be the key. Changing the size of an image while maintaining the same look is called scaling. As we saw with my posters, in order to scale something correctly, you have to equally adjust both how tall and how wide the image is. Now that we know I need to adjust both the height and the width of the image to get it just right, let's go back and fix the other two posters. Remember Mount St. Helens? In my poster, I only scaled the image vertically. We should match that and scale it horizontally as well to clean this one up. How about the Gulf of Mexico? In my poster, I only scaled the horizontal dimension of this photo. We should scale its vertical dimension as well to balance out the proportions. Wow. After those adjustments, these posters look so much better. Ooh, you know what? I actually attempted to scale some other images of places I want to travel to in the future. Will you help me look through them and decide which ones have been scaled correctly? This sculpture is well known as the Bean in Chicago. Can you tell which of these two images I scaled correctly? Pause here and write down what you notice. It looks like image A has been scaled correctly, while for image B, it looks like only the horizontal measurements were changed. What do you think about this next one? I want to see some bison roaming in the wild in South Dakota, but they're such big animals, I need to scale this one down smaller. We always call this process scaling, whether we're making something larger or smaller. So, which one is scaled correctly? Pause here and mark this one in your notes. Image C is correct in this one. I know bison are tall and big, but I can tell image A was only scaled vertically, and image B was only scaled horizontally. Have you heard of Old Faithful? It's a famous geyser in Yellowstone National Park. I found this small picture online, and I need to make it larger. Which of these images did I scale up correctly? Pause and record your observations in your notes. Image B is the correctly scaled image because it was scaled both vertically and horizontally. Image A was only scaled vertically. And look at image C. It was scaled both horizontally and vertically, but it was scaled way more horizontally. The adjustments need to be equal in both directions to be properly scaled. Finally, I want to hike up to the Hollywood sign in California. Which of these four images looks like it was scaled correctly? Pause and write down what you notice in your notes. Image B is the correct answer again because both measurements were scaled equally. Image A is scaled too wide because only the horizontal measurement was changed. Image C is too tall because only the vertical measurement was changed. And image D was scaled in both directions, but it looks like it was scaled more vertically than horizontally. Thank you so much for your help today. Now we know when you want to scale an image or make it smaller or larger, you need to adjust both the horizontal and vertical measurements to keep it in proportion. Once you're done watching this video and finishing up your guided notes, you can move on to levels 1 through 3 in the online practice. Until next time, keep questioning, keep calculating, and remember, whether scaling something larger or smaller, adjust the width and the height to make it just right. See you next time! Hey.